The Board of Education on Thursday, June 28th, Stanley T. Williams Community Center at 6 o'clock, says the bell. Roll call.
Chairman Papaholzer?
Here.
Vice Chair Onofrio?
Here.
Secretary Sienna? Jana Balsamo?
Here.
Carolyn Candelora?
Here.
Vincent Mace? Cynthia Rice?
Here.
Salute the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Discussion and possible actions regarding the North Branford Intermediate School principal position.
I don't have a motion, but I can make a motion.
We really don't need a motion for this. You just have to direct me to post, similar to what we did with the last one that we did. And if you're all in favor, I will post that and start the process.
Okay.
So, I'm in agreement with that.
Can we take a roll call vote to post the position for the North Branford Intermediate School principal position?
But we didn't really make a motion, so should we make a motion?
Let's vote on it. I don't think we need a motion. We need to give a directive, but I just want it to be a majority. Is that okay?
Yeah, it's fine.
Can I click? I'm sorry.
Yeah.
What's the...
Oh, we're made to give the directive to post for the North Branford Intermediate School position.
Principal position. With the timeline of interviewing, posting now in June, interviewing in July, coming with a candidate in August.
Chairman Papaholzer?
Yes.
Vice Chair Onofrio?
Yes.
Secretary Sienna?
Yes.
I'm sorry, Ben.
Yes.
Jana Balsamo?
Yes.
Carolyn Candelora?
Yes.
Cynthia Rice?
Yes.
Discussion and possible action regarding the 2018-2019 budget. So Scott, do you want to talk a little bit about it? And then we'll make one of the motions that's been prepared.
Yes, obviously since our last meeting that we had with budget discussions, we have had subsequent discussions and the directive of looking at ways of crafting a budget that would eliminate the pay to participate at the middle and high school. So the sheets that you're looking at in front of you are similar to what you had seen at our last meeting, but also now incorporated in that sheet would be the elimination of pay to participate and the ways in which we would do that.
So based on what I'm seeing here, the motion that I made at the last meeting is pretty much the same. The only difference is we're eliminating the pay to participate.
Correct.
And to offset that, we are reducing custodial, substitute, and overtime pay by $40,000.
That's correct.
Now, I'm gonna vote for the budget because it's June 28th and we need to have a budget, but I'm not saying, I was never for pay to participate to begin with. I fought it as long as I possibly could. We now have it. Doesn't seem to be that big of a problem. We're taking it out. But the only thing that I'm having issue with is it's at the 11th hour that all of a sudden it's being taken out. It's never been discussed, not at one single solitary budget meeting, not at one budget subcommittee meeting, not here. We've never discussed it. And I mean, I'm gonna vote for it. I'm sorry, but we're probably gonna have to put it back in another budget season or two. We're gonna have to put the pay to participate back in, and it's fine. But like, we didn't have any discussion about it. Nothing. It never came up. That's not being really prudent on our part.
Or transparent, as we keep saying we're going to be.
Yeah.
I think moving forward in budget seasons, we're gonna see more transparency. What I've talked to Scott about as I was meeting with Scott and Don, is that we're going to do budgets three different ways so that we're prepared, so that we're going to do a flatline budget, a superintendent's budget, and a status quo budget, so we know exactly what the budgets will look like when we're voting on them. So no matter what we get from town council, we know exactly what our budget's going to be. The administrators will know, parents will know, we'll be having more dialogue of where we're thinking about cutting, where we think about adding, what new initiatives we need for curriculum. So we're gonna do it more of a process moving on. We all kind of jumped on new. Mm-hmm. And there is some areas of, I'll call it fluff, but that's not the right word. I'm just lacking a better word. So, but there are areas that can be reduced, and there's are to put in different things. But I think as we move forward and this team comes together, and I keep saying it, I want to move seven people forward, not a 4-3 split. And the more we talk about it and the more we figure things out, the more we'll be able to share ideas more readily. And when it does get heated, we're going to have a different kind of respect and trust amongst each other that will help build this. And hopefully we'll build a better relationship with the town council and the administrative team so that there's more of a team effort and a give and take. I had a young lady write a letter to the board, and I won't mention her name, but she definitely was very well spoken, and she is a graduate of North Branford, and I'd like to publicly thank her. She knows who she is. It is my role to make sure that I am always leading in a positive way, and I'd like to thank her for making me self-reflect, and I will do my best to try, even if I have an opposing view, to make sure that I'm sharing in a very positive light. So thank you. Now we can.
Okay, wait, I just have one question.
Sure.
So we're gonna make up the $40,000, we're gonna get rid of the pay for play, that we're gonna get rid of overtime for custodians.
We're not getting rid of it. We're trimming
it.
That line by.
How can you guarantee you can reduce it? Because obviously you're paying it now, you must need it.
Well, there's a number of parts to this. A lot of the overtime for custodian comes during snow days.
Okay.
So our fingers are crossed next winter that we're not gonna have a lot of snow days. But we're certainly, we're hedging on that. And we're gonna have to adjust as we get to that, similar to what we do in other areas. So that was an area that we discussed and we looked at. The largest part is for snow removal or for projects that are done in the summertime by our custodial staff. We're just gonna have to be really on top of all of that and make sure that we're staying within the established number that we have.
And one of the issues, just so you know, Jenna, that we looked at, is a large number of it was substitute. So we didn't wanna cut a custodial position. I definitely heard that loud and clear, but a lot of the substitutes come at like a one day kind of thing, not a long vacation. So what we talked about was if a custodian's gonna be gone for a week, they get a substitute, but if they're gonna be gone for a sick day, most positions don't get a substitute for a sick day other than a teacher. So we talked about what schools would be negatively impacted, like TVS and Jerome only have one custodian on shift, so they will get a substitute. However, NBIS and the high school have multiple custodians, so they can pick up during that time so that there would still be no break. So that's how we did it. We did it thoughtfully. We didn't kind of just.
No, I know, but I just need to cut something and be like, oh, we're going to hope for no snow. I mean, that doesn't seem very.
Well, here's the breakdown.
I mean,
you have two custodians at NBIS at night, two.
Okay.
One during the day. The high school has two at night, one during the day.
Mm-hmm.
The auditorium has one in between, and that gentleman splits his 8-hour shift between the auditorium and then goes over. So the thought process is if one is out, that auditorium person will come and fill. So the auditorium is going to be the buffer. Now, things are not gonna potentially get done in there. We know that, we understand, because you're taking a body out of there. So we're trying to be creative with how we do that. The good news is this brings our custodial level back up by bringing a position back on, and that was our goal.
Yeah. So my
right.
question
so just
to
for
you
clarity,
is,
so everyone understands that if you do support this budget, I am then going to reinstate, and there's other positions that we potentially have that I'm going to post and run and then bring you back in here to vote on. The custodian position will not be one of them, but for teaching positions, for any resignations that I have, or for unfilled positions with resignations that we had at the end of this year, I'll conduct, run, but then bring you back in this summer to do it.
So my question to you is, with cutting the custodial overtime, are you confident that that's going to be okay? You've been charged one of your goals.
I'm confident to say that we have a creative way to bring a position back, and that I'm going to monitor it this year and have a better idea next year to come back to you and say, you know what, we need to adjust a little bit. Let's hedge this way. Let's hedge that way. Or everything worked. So I'm comfortable with that.
That's what you get paid the big bucks for.
Right.
You mentioned open positions or posting. Are we privy to that?
Like everything that goes out, you will get.
Okay.
Everything that goes out. Like you just did the principal's position.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to have a meeting every time post something. It's only going to be for certified staff, so you're not going to get anything for paraprofessionals or things like that. We'll do those because I don't think you want to come back in here if I hire 8 paraprofessionals over the summer to come back in 8 different times.
But just like an overall list of how many positions
you'll get that through email. Right, and then I'll call the meeting. I'll give advance notice. We'll post it and everything for you to come in and do like we did tonight.
Okay.
All right. Anything else, guys, or can I make a motion? Make a motion to approve the operating budget in the amount of $31,647,175 as follows, contingent upon a temporary $350,000 reduction to be allocated by future budgetary line item transfers as required. I guess he wants me to read them all, right? Reduce Object 111 certified salaries by $195,393. Reduce Object 112 non-certified salaries by $260,579. Reduce Object 211 FICA and Medicare by $4,388,000. Increase Object 212 unemployment by $15,938. Reduce Object 213 health insurance by $47,054. Reduce Object 510 transportation by $51,000. Reduce Object 611 instructional supplies by $42,196. And increase Object 810 dues and fees by $40,000. Total reduction $544,672.
I second. Discussion?
I'm going to support this budget, but the one aspect I would like to look at for next year, due to the fact that I didn't know what we were exactly asking for, the K through 5 music teacher, along with adding general music to TVS, I'm going to stand by this budget, but I would like to look at that to maybe take correct action for next year with the music, please.
So that's great. That's a good suggestion. So when we meet in July, we're going to develop goals with Scott, and they're going to align with the budget. So that's a good time. What we're going to do, and we're going to have that whiteboard up. We're going to put all of the goals up. We're going to see where the budget's going to go.
And I think you want to evaluate how programs are going.
Mm-hmm.
That's the reason you made the decision to do that, not because of comments or anything else that you may be getting. I know it was a hot issue on Facebook, and there's a lot of conversation. But we're charged with being fiscally responsible. And if we're able to provide a rich program for them within the budget monies that we have, we'll take a look at it.
Yeah, and that's
as we build the budget next year.
Yeah, we can look at that for budgets and goals. Further discussion? Roll call vote.
Chairman Papa Holter?
Yes.
Vice Chair Anafrio?
Yes.
Secretary Sienna?
Yes.
Jana Balsamo?
Yes.
Carolyn Candelora?
Yes.
Cynthia Rice?
Yes.
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.